I told my friend that dragons exist, and they know something about our origin. Scientists won't let us know the secret. My friend got shocked and wanted to see him, and we both went to that location where the dragon was present. She asked where it is. I said I forgot to tell you, it is an invisible fire dragon. So she said no problem, we can spread white powder on the ground to see his footprint. My stupid friend didn't know that this dragon can float. Then she said we can spray paint to make him visible. I said it is not made up of matter. Then finally she said we can detect fire in the infrared sensor. I told her that it produces heatless fire. But before my friend gets angry, I gave her some piece of evidence. I told her that the dragon revealed to me that alien brings life to this earth. They visited many times to the earth bringing important information about the earth and the outside. But sometimes people encounter him. Scientists also know this secret, that's why they hide UFOs from us. Even though my friend couldn't test this claim, but shouldn't she accept the evidence I gave to her? This problem also scratched the head of Karl Popper. In his time there were many theories that he considered dubious to be called science. The problem was not that they didn't have any evidence, but these theories had many evidence to confirm their theories. It was around a time when science taking a big leap, when Einstein gave the theory of relativity. But there were three other theories also: Marx's theory, Adler's theory of individual psychology, and Freud's theory of psychoanalysis. These three theories could explain everything in their fields, and that was the biggest problem. When you believe something to be true, you look for evidence that confirms your belief, and can make connections that do not have any at all. As Karl Popper said, once your eyes were thus opened, you saw confirmed instances everywhere. The world was full of verifications of the theory. Whatever happened always confirmed it. In order to demarcate science from what he called pseudoscience, he said scientific theories have two important features. They are testable and falsifiable. That is, you can test these theories, and if you can test, then there is room to falsify them. Our attempt should be to falsify a theory rather than looking for confirming evidence. As Carl Sagan said in his dragon story, which I mentioned in starting. Now, what's the difference between an invisible, incorporeal, floating dragon who spits heatless fire and no dragon at all? If there's no way to disprove my contention, no conceivable experiment that would count against it, what does it mean to say that my dragon exists? How scientific theories were tested and falsified, we look at the interesting theories of vision. How we see objects around us was mysterious for a very long time. There were two important theories of vision among Greeks, the intromission and the extromission theory. Democritus believed that all substances were composed of atoms and retain the property of a large substance. Which means if you are looking towards a tree, then it gives off some particle that retains the tree-like property it enters your eyes and you are able to see the tree. Plato gave the extromission theory. He said, I send something towards the object, hit it, and come back with the information, and we are able to see the object. Aristotle considered extramission theory absurd, as it is impossible that rays from eyes reach the stars. Then finally Ibn Al-Haytham, better known as Al-Hazen in the Western, said that light plays an important role in seeing object. The light hit the object and traveled back into our eyes. He proved this with the help of camera obscura, proving those two theories wrong. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel.